good to have you with us on the 8 p.m. edition of the Urban Debate. There seems to be no end to the chaos and confusion in the Congress party. Twists after twist and some more drama. Every time the party leadership claims that they have resolved the matter, all is well. They have come up with master strokes to fix the entire issue. There is one more chaos that gets unleashed. And if you haven't heard it yet, the unprecedented twist came today when the Punjab Congress chief, Navjot Singh Sidhu, who's been after Captain Amrinder, after his own party in Punjab, pointing out problems with Punjab government, got himself installed as the Punjab Congress chief just a couple of months ago. Today, tweeted his resignation. And he said that I can never compromise on Punjab's future. His letter actually began by him saying the collapse of a man's character stems from the compromise corner. And I can never compromise on Punjab's future. Can't compromise the agenda for the welfare of Punjab. Will continue to serve the Congress party. This was the googly from Navjot Singh Sidhu earlier in the day. It's not stopped there. Four of Sidhu's close aides, including two cabinet ministers, ministers who actually just took oath 2 days ago in the new cabinet under Chief Minister Channi, have also resigned in solidarity with Navjot Singh Sidhu. Not only that, two other Congress Punjab unit office post bearers have also tweeted and announced their resignation. Now, some sources within the party seem to indicate that the resignation of Sidhu hasn't been accepted. And the leadership is asking the state unit to resolve this crisis. I really wonder who are they right now talking about. Through the day, no commentary coming in from the party high command. Rahul Gandhi was at a public event. He was asked questions there. He did not respond. The Congress party held a news briefing to announce the induction of Kanhaiya Kumar, who's moved from left to the Congress party. They also welcomed Jignesh Mevani. Hardik was also there. But no questions were taken on Sidhu's exit. Media was told, we will answer all your questions. First, let's talk about these two who are present here. That didn't happen. The minute the conversation was over, no more questions were taken. So there's absolute stunned silence from the party leadership. Except, of course, Captain Amrinder, who is in Delhi today and has very clearly gone on and said, I told you so. This man is not stable, is not fit to lead a state like Punjab. So what's going on? And is this now really the Congress party's biggest disaster and crisis ahead of 2022 polls in the state of Punjab? Can they really come back from this and still win the state elections? I say good evening to Sudesh Sharma of the BJP, Sujata Paul, political analyst, Dr. Sunny Ahluwalia, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party, Anand Mishra, political editor and chief of bureau for Deccan Herald, and Narendranath Mishra, assistant editor at Navbharat Times, also joining me this evening. Narendra, let's start off with you. Last I checked, which was a few minutes ago before we started with the headlines, in all, Sidhu and four others had tendered their resignation. I don't know in these few minutes if there's been an update, because that's how quickly things are changing. What is going on?
Later, Pargat Singh ne resign kiya hai, but the unhone officially chuki communicate nahi kiya hai, and he's going to meet Pargat Sidhu. So after meeting, wo Sidhu officially kahenge. Abhi jo reports aa rahi hai, 4 to 5 ministers close to Sidhu likely to resign from government. In the same time, Congress ke leadership TV channel open hua hai, Sidhu se connect karne ki koshish ki ja rahi hai, Sidhu se किसी की बात नहीं हो पा रही है. एंड फ्रैंकली जो सिद्धू का जो मूव था वो कांग्रेस लीडरशिप के लिए एकदम अनएक्सपेक्टेड था. सो फॉलोअप क्या होगा अभी इवन कांग्रेस के लोगों को भी पता नहीं है कितने लोग उनके साथ जाएंगे. एंड मोर इम्पोर्टेंटली वो आगे क्या करने वाले हैं उस मतलब सभी एकदम ब्लाइंड स्पॉट में है अभी. एंड जैसा आपने देखा इन सारी चीजों से अमरिंदर एकदम आई टोल्ड यू सो वाले मूड में आ चुके हैं. तो ये जो रात है जो मतलब पंजाब कांग्रेस एंड सेंट्रल लीडर उनके लिए बहुत ही टफ होगा। यहाँ से अब चीजों को करेक्ट करना इस ऑलमोस्ट बहुत ही हिमालयन टास्क है।
ये बहुत एक मैं आपसे ट्रिकी क्वेश्चन पूछने वाली हूँ नरेंद्र, क्योंकि सिद्धू को अगर जानते हैं जो लोग, वो यही कहेंगे कि वो इतने अनप्रेडिक्टेबल है कि बोलना बहुत मुश्किल है। लेकिन क्या हो रहा है, क्या सोच के वो ये कर रहे हैं दैट नॉट ओनली हिम, सो मेनी ऑफ हिज एड्स एंड बैकर्स आर ऑल्सो रिजाइनिंग फ्रॉम वेरियस पोस्ट फॉर हिम, इज दिस सम काइंड ऑफ अ शो ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ टू गेट हिज वे, और इज ही एक्चुअली गोइंग टू वॉक अवे नाउ एंड गो एल्सवेयर?
सिद्धू सिंस 2017 से अगर आप सिद्धू के पॉलिटिकल जर्नी को अगर देखें या उनके पॉलिटिकल एस्पिरेशन को देखें, तो उनकी प्राइमरली व्हाट एवर जो भी पार्टी हो उनकी प्राइमरली एस्पिरेशन थी कि पंजाब का सीएम बनना है। वो उसके नीचे उनका कम का एस्पिरेशन नहीं थी। 17 में भी अगर उस वक्त के पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट को देखें तो उस वक्त उनकी आम आदमी पार्टी से बात हो रही थी कि आप सीएम हो सकते नहीं हो सकते। लेकिन बाद में उस वक्त याद होगा अमरिंदर सिंह के साथ सब लोग कांग्रेस लीडरशिप के प्रशांत किशोर थे, सब लोगों ने मिलकर उस वक्त सिद्धू को मना लिया था कि आप अगले फेस आप ही होंगे। लेकिन उनकी फिर भी वो रहे, 3 साल रहे, सरकार चली, अभी जो डेवलपमेंट हुआ सारा। अब भी जब चन्नी को बना दिया गया और जब लीडरशिप ने उनको स्पष्ट कम्युनिकेट कर दिया गया कि इवन आफ्टर रिजल्ट के बाद भी अगर कांग्रेस जीतती है तो चन्नी ही सीएम फेस होंगे, तब यहाँ उनको लगा कि अब यहाँ से मेरे लिए अब कांग्रेस में जो जिसके लिए मैं इतने दिन से इंतजार कर रहा था, मेरे लिए अब रास्ता नहीं है। ये उनका एक पॉलिटिकल लाइन था। रास्ता जो बनाया उन्होंने, जो कई सारे जो अपॉइंटमेंट्स हुए, जो डीजीपी हुए या जो जो उनके लॉ डिपार्टमेंट में हुए, उनको इश्यूज बना के एक जो रिजाइन का जो इन्होंने किया है। लेकिन इसका बैकग्राउंड में इनकी जो एक एस्पिरेशन थी कि सीएम से कुछ कम नहीं लेंगे, याद होगा को डिप्टी सीएम के लिए तैयार नहीं हो रहे थे, तो एक लग रहा है कि चन्नी आने के बाद उनका जो कांग्रेस ने एग्रेसिवली दलित कार्ड खेला, जिसके लिए इवन पैन इंडिया मैसेज है जहां से अब कांग्रेस चाह के भी बैकऑफ नहीं कर सकती है, यहाँ एक ऐसी सिचुएशन है जहां से कांग्रेस बैकऑफ भी नहीं कर सकती है वहां से, तो इसीलिए सिद्धू के लिए अब जो यहां से अब उनको वापसी अब बहुत मुश्किल लग रही है कांग्रेस में।
वापसी बहुत मुश्किल लग रही है कांग्रेस में। इनफैक्ट जो आपने ये पॉइंट उठाया, दैट्स व्हाट आई वांटेड टू रेज, बिकॉज देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ बज, मिस्टर आनंद मिश्रा, गुड इवनिंग टू यू, अ लॉट ऑफ बज अबाउट हाउ सिद्धू वाज नॉट हैप्पी विद सम ऑफ द कैबिनेट अपॉइंटमेंट्स और द नेम दैट ही वांटेड टू गो फॉर एडवोकेट जनरल बज वाज नॉट टेकन। आर ऑल ऑफ दीज एक्चुअली जस्ट रीजंस एंड एक्सक्यूजेस बीइंग गिवन, एंड इज द बिगर स्टोरी दैट सिद्धू नाउ न्यू ही वोंट बिकम चीफ मिनिस्टर इफ ही स्टेज विद द कांग्रेस?
गुड इवनिंग तन्वी, राइट इन सेइंग हाइलाइटिंग दिस पॉइंट दैट परहैप्स मिस्टर सिद्धू नाउ न्यू दैट ही वुड नॉट बी द सीएम अगेन, बिकॉज यू सी द काइंड ऑफ प्रोजेक्शन दैट कांग्रेस पार्टी डिड आफ्टर मेकिंग चनी चीफ मिनिस्टर, after that going back would have been very difficult for them. Also if you see the function of Mr. Channi in last few days, he has not left anyone in doubt that he is there for a long haul, because we don't see the airs of a temporary chief minister in the way Mr. Channi has functioned so far, in the way he has selected his new cabinet, ignoring Sidhu's objections and all that. So basically, you see Congress party now in Punjab, where its two most prominent faces, I mean, Captain Amrinder Singh, the former chief minister, and Navjot Sidhu, this Punjab state chief, both are sulking, and they have not left the party, they are within the party. So the sulk is only growing, and if you see three cabinet ministers, I think four, you said, having resigned after in protest in solidarity with Mr. Sidhu, which means that the larger number of the leaders in the Congress who are working for the party are sulking lot. So I don't know how this sulking lot Congress is going to elections, how they will counter the anti-incumbency against Captain Amarinder Singh government. Each day is getting it tougher for the party to repeat its short in power.
But it's extremely interesting, and you know, I think right now nobody is able to really justify what's gone on and how the leadership has handled this. Sujata Paul, so much drama. One veteran leader who kept on saying, do not go with him, do not depend on him, do not trust him. And yet the party leadership decided to do that. And look where it's brought you. It all seems to be falling apart now.
Well, I won't say everything is falling apart. What is everything? That is the point. The master stroke still remains that Mr. Charanjit Singh Channi is the chief minister of Punjab. And if anybody says that, anybody in any party says that that's not a correct move, come find that person for me. Nobody is saying it. As far as Mr. Navjot Singh Sindhu is concerned, what has happened over there, we will also have to wait and watch because, like you said, nobody's being able to contact him at the moment. For us, today is a very important day. If you look at it politically, it just shows that politics has become, people blackmailing parties or trying to defect from one party to the other. And yes, the BJP will be very happy, but BJP also had the same gentleman with them from 2004 to 2016. So BJP has no business to be pointing fingers at him at all. What Mr. Sidhu's problem is, we will come to know in a day or two. So we need to wait and watch. It is an important day today in the politics of this country because two young leaders have been inducted by the Congress. And if you notice, like you yourself said, it is business as usual for them. Why is it business as usual? Because the state leadership has been told that you have to handle this problem. And as far as Mr. Channi is concerned, he has the support of the leadership, central leadership. And thirdly, the most important thing, they are going about business as usual because they know that whatever will happen will be in the best interest of the people of Punjab. So let's wait and watch. Mr. Captain Amrinder Singh, of course, saying that I told you so, I don't think that holds any water as well. Because what is he talking about and what has happened are two different things.
How?
We don't know why Mr. Sidhu has resigned. Because if you look at his letter, he has said very clearly that, when he's talking about compromise, he's also talking about staying in the Congress party. If you look at that second line of his letter, it is very clear that he's talking about that he does not want any kind of a problem for maybe himself or it could be for the party. So we'll
you don't think, Sujata, this is a problem for the party? You genuinely don't think this is a problem that two cabinet ministers have quit, two party office bearers have quit, the man who fought so much for whom Rahul and Priyanka fought and installed him there, the man because of whom Captain Amrinder had to walk away, has now resigned as the PCC chief and is creating this drama, throwing tantrums, refusing to talk to anybody. Your entire party is clueless about what is going on. Nobody knows what Sidhu is thinking and you don't think this is a problem.
No, I'll tell you why. Because Captain Amrinder Singh, we know very well, every survey was telling us that Captain Amrinder Singh is no longer popular in the state of Punjab. However, people are looking at the Congress party. If you remember, for the Kisan movement also, what did Captain Amrinder say? You should go elsewhere and start your protest. So the farmers were also going against him. And definitely the Congress party wouldn't have wanted him to, wanted the Kisans or the farmers to go against the party because the Congress party has been supporting them and they support any person's protest against this government where the government is wrong. And as far as the party is concerned, the party is still there. If there are people who are resigning, these are people who are probably from, Mr. Sidhu's camp. Yeah. So let's wait and watch. Let's not jump to conclusions right now is what I would like to say.
Okay. So Sudesh Verma, Sujata Paul says that when Captain says, I told you so, he's been talking about something very different and there is no problem. But I think before the Captain, the BJP can say that. The BJP can say, I told you so. Sidhu is not to be trusted.
You see, Tanvi, I was actually trying to figure out the accent of Sujata because she's more confident in the Congress spokesperson. Their newfound hero, Kanhaiya, today said that Congress is a sinking ship and he's going to revive that. And today, you are saying that nothing is going to happen. You see, Sidhu is one of the biggest entertainers, whether he was in cricket or in, TV show, but he could not find a role in the BJP as an entertainer. So he had to shift. And then he went to the Congress and he found that a green ground in the Congress, you see, and he's entertaining people. It's a drama. It's a drama and you would end up calling it a farce. I'll tell you why. It's quite possible that the central leaders of the Congress, they've asked Sidhu to do this because they may have realized that they've done a mistake by appointing someone from a Dalit background as chief minister in a politics that is dominated by Jet 6. And that may be the reason that now that Captain Amrinder Singh is out, now that Chenni can also be out. And Sidhu is their bet. Otherwise, why would Sidhu still keep the option of staying in the Congress if he was serious about his vocation? He says that I won't compromise. So he is compromising by being in the Congress, isn't it? So the whole episode appears to be a cooked up episode, and only the Congress leadership would be able to tell. That is why they have said, go back to the state will resolve. The state would do so, but Mr. Rahul Gandhi or the entire family sits together and decides. There seems to be a void in the family itself. Who is backing whom is not clear. But for us, you see, it's not our doing, but we will enjoy like every person in this country is enjoying, because Sidhu is an entertainer. We take him to be an entertainer. We don't take him in politics very seriously.
Yeah, except Rahul and Priyanka Gandhi, who did take him very seriously. Sujata Paul.
Yes, you know, I like the way Mr. Verma is talking about Sidhu. From 2004 to 2016, 12 years, he was an entertainer. He was an MP from Amritsar for two times.
He
was
not entertained. He did not find the BJP to be a good ground to become an entertainer. That is why he was doing a TV show. This is what I said.
So Mr. Verma, 12 years, you made an entertainer a politician of your party, and you made him an MP, a Rajya Sabha MP as well. So don't come up with this. And you're talking about a Dalit leader versus Jat Singh. Are you against a Dalit leader? Why? Why are you against a Dalit leader? And third thing, you're saying the leadership has put it up.
Did I say that? Why are you putting words into my mouth?
Gandhi,
you realize your mistake.
That Rahul Gandhi is in full control. That's what you're saying. So there is no problem. You can talk whatever you
want to say. I don't need to clarify on my own statement, isn't it?
Admitting that Rahul Gandhi is in control and that's why this has happened. Let's wait and watch. Why are you jumping into conclusions?
There is one point that Sudesh Sharma made, and I want to talk about that, and we could go through that aspect in just a bit. But let me bring in Dr. Sunny Ahluwalia, because Dr. Ahluwalia, the BJP is done, the Congress party is pretty much done, unless they really, you know, believe that they haven't self-destructed enough and they want to stick on to Sidhu. Is the Aam Aadmi Party now considering the option of taking Sidhu?
Sidhu, I can still say that Sidhu is like a bhule basre geet, and he has five symptoms. Five symptoms how we can recognize Sidhu is, number one, he is completely missing political intelligence. Number one, that is the most important one. Number two is imbalanced politically opportunistic. He is very opportunistic. First he was in BJP, then he jumped into Congress. Now he may be seeking to make his own party or something else. Aam Aadmi Party is not taking him. Third is sign of political fatigue. Then fourth is political fears. And we can say, fifth is that in case there is some kind of prize in which they say that world most hated politicians, then Sidhu will be in first 10. And Congress is doing same what it has done with Sitaram Kesari. You must remember Sitaram Kesari, what the Congress has done with them. And the same thing is going to happen with Sidhu. Sidhu is like Sukhbir Badal said, that it's like undecided missile. It may fall anywhere. So undirected missile rather. So it is very clear that Sidhu is now trying to break Congress, or Captain is trying to break Congress. Nothing is clear. In next 10 minutes, you will come to know that Chief Minister have resigned. So they are undecided people. They have no faith in what welfare they want to do for people of Punjab. They are only bothered about themselves and nothing else. And when you talk about BJP, BJP is very clear that they have made these three black laws. Now, whatever they can do, they can see that they have lost their field in Punjab and all over India rather.
One specific point that Sudesh Sharma raised, and let me ask this question to Narendranath Mishra. Narendra, you know, information has also been put out by Congress sources to say, well, the party leadership has not accepted his resignation and they've told the state unit to handle it. Now, who is the state unit that is going to actually handle Sidhu and his tantrums?
No, if it happens, then central leadership may be, and central leadership means only Gandhi. अब यहाँ से सिद्धू को ये कर सकते हैं, निगोशिएट कर सकते हैं, नो वन, कोई दूसरा नहीं कर सकता है सिद्धू को, इवन नॉट इवन सीएम या कोई दूसरा, हरीश रावत या कोई दूसरा, कोई भी अगर पवन बंसल जो भी जाएंगे वो अलग। लेकिन इस जो टोटल अभी पंजाब क्राइसिस को देखने के लिए अगर आपको एक साल पहले अगर रिवाइंड करके अगर हम देखें तो कुछ चीजें पूरी क्लियर होती है। एक साल पहले पंजाब में कांग्रेस कंप्लीटली एक कंफर्ट जोन में चली गई थी कि वो एक फार्मर प्रोटेस्ट हो रहा था, अकालीज उतने पॉपुलर नहीं थे, आपके पास सीएम का फेस नहीं था, लोकसभा में हार गई थी। सो कंप्लीटली एक साल पहले वो कंप्लीटली इस जोन में चली गई कि इलेक्शन होना है और मुझे जीत के हम सीधे आ जाएंगे, 80-90 सीट आ जाएंगे। एंड परसेप्शन यही था, नैरेटिव यही थी, समहाउ ये ठीक था, बट उसके चलते इनका कोई ग्राउंड फीडबैक नहीं था। सडनली इनके पास ग्राउंड फीडबैक आया कि अमरिंदर इज ह्यूजली अनपॉपुलर, एंटी इनकम्बेंसी बहुत हो जा रही है, सम ऑफ फैक्ट था, एमएलए शिकायत कर रहे थे एसेसेबल नहीं थे, एट पैरेलल सिद्धू कैप्टन को अपोज कर रहे थे, वो रेबेलियन हो रहे थे। तो यहाँ पे लोगों ने, स्टेट लीडरशिप ने और कई लोगों ने, मीडिया ने माना कि जो एमएलए का रेबेलियन है और सिद्धू का जो अपोज है वो दोनों एक पिच पे है। ये फैक्ट था कि दोनों का अपोज वो कैप्टन के खिलाफ थे, बट सिद्धू के पास भी इतना बड़ा मैंडेट नहीं था कि वो कंप्लीटली कैप्टन को रिप्लेस कर सके। तो इन सब सारे चीजों में कैप्टन वर्सेस एमएलए, कैप्टन वर्सेस सिद्धू एंड बाकी जो चीजें थी वो सारी मिस में हो गई कि कांग्रेस के लिए कोई ऐसा होता है कि कोई एक जहाँ पे होल है या कोई एक जगह आपको एक ही घाव हो तो जिसको ठीक करे। तो ये मल्टीपल ये ऑर्गन फेलियर जैसी हालत है यहाँ पे कांग्रेस की कि जहाँ पे कोई एक सिद्धू को मना लेंगे तो क्या होगा। तो कई सारे चीजें इतनी जगह पे आ चुकी हैं जहाँ पे वहां पे कोई एक स्टेट लीडर, जैसे आपने कहा यू राइटली पॉइंटेड कि स्टेट लीडरशिप के ये बूते की बात नहीं है, ये यहाँ जब जो होगा वो गांधी के पास भी होगा और अब उनके लिए भी बहुत लिमिटेड ऑप्शन हो गए हैं क्योंकि आप ए करेंगे तो बी प्रॉब्लम होगा, बी करेंगे सी प्रॉब्लम होगा, उतना टाइम नहीं है, एंटी इनकम्बेंसी भी आ चुकी है, डिलीवरी का टाइम नहीं है। तो मतलब जो कम्प्लीटली एक ऐसा केस है जहाँ पे आईसीयू से पहले तो निकले एक पेशेंट, उसके बाद फिर बाकी चीजें इलाज हो।
तो आईसीयू में पहुंच गए, शायद वो भी ज्यादा कारण नहीं था, अपने आप ही चले गए एडमिशन लेने वहां पे। दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन वी आर लुकिंग एट राइट नाउ। आनंद मिश्रा, what are the options? Narendranath Mishra doesn't see too many options really available right now for the party to fix this anymore. Captains obviously are going to be difficult to now pacify. Sidhu has now started this tantrum. Is the Congress party expected to then fight the election under the leadership of Mr. Channi?
See, Tanvi, who shall decide when doctors disagree, says Beckham. So it's that kind of scenario in Punjab that party high command has asked state unit to handle the designation of state unit chief. It's a really intriguing scenario. But as far as Mr. Charanjit Singh Channi's appointment is concerned, I will still cautious in writing the obituary of Congress on that. Because how this appointment plays out is yet to be seen. Because this is the first time Dalit has been appointed as chief minister in Punjab. And it's true that it's, the politics has been dominated by Jat Sikh. But the fact that 35% population of Punjab is Dalits, that cannot be ignored. And we have to see how this assertion of Dalit plays out there. And if you see today's cabinet portfolio allocation, Mr. Randhawa has been made home minister. So, Jat Sikh, prominent leader who has been reached out and given a prime portfolio, he is the man whose appointment as chief minister was opposed by Mr. Sidhu. So, while Sidhu and Captain are out, Congress is indeed making some efforts to reach out to Jat Sikhs also. So, how this Jat Sikh and Dalit combination plays out in the time to come, in the months to come, that is yet to be seen because that's a new test, that's a new experiment whose outcome is yet not out.
Okay, now I wanted to understand what really changed between Sidhu becoming the PCC chief, Captain Amrinder resigning, new cabinet coming into this point. But like Sujata, you said, the Congress party also doesn't know, and the party leadership is also still trying to figure out what this compromise corner is. Is there any insight you can share on what is this compromise corner that Mr. Sidhu is talking about?
Certainly not. That is exactly what I'm saying. We'll just have to wait and watch. And I'll go with what Mr. Verma said. That said, the central leadership knows what is happening. So, you know, that's all that I can say, because nobody has spoken about, you know, it from the central leadership. And look at Mr. Verma. What is he so happy about? The BJP has no standing in Punjab. They were in a coalition with the Akali Dal, and that's why they had any kind of relevance. Right now, I don't think they need to, you know, jump into this.
But they didn't do that to themselves. The Congress party seems to be going to that level by themselves.
Can I respond to
me? Yes, Sudhir Sharma.
Then we see, it's very simple if you want to understand politics. And if you want to complicate it, it is a very complicated issue. It's simple is that Sidhu was going to run the Punjab administration from behind. He was going to do the backseat driving, which was not allowed by Cherry. So tomorrow, when the Congress goes to Paul, of course, Sidhu was to be projected as the chief minister. So Cherry knows that what he's there for is a stopgap arrangement. So he started asserting, which Sidhu didn't like. And he has raised his, fingers. So now the central leadership has to decide. And they have to resolve the issue, because Sidhu is one man who is not going to compromise, as he has said. That is as good as falling, isn't it? He won't fall. So he would fight for his right, what was committed by the central leadership to Sidhu. And of course, he's mercurial. And, you know, Captain Amrinder Singh has said so many things about him. We all agree with what Captain Amrinder Singh has said, because he knows Sidhu much better. Punjab being a border state, he cannot be the right bet. But it is for the Congress to decide, isn't it? It's as simple as that.
Mr. Verma, you're right. You know, you really, encouraged somebody into becoming a mercurial person for 12 years. Come on, look at yourself. You had him with you for 12 years. Stop making fun of people.
We are the brunt of his temperament, isn't it? Thanks, God, for taking this.
Really is not the point. The point is that you had him with you for 12 long years and you're making fun of it. That means you have
those things. No. Vyasaji, but he did not do any of those things. He was entertaining only on television shows. He did not find a ground in politics to entertain.
You to get down and understand the ground situation in Uttarakhand. There are places from where China has entered. Stop them. Stop worrying about Mr. Sidhu. That's my suggestion to you.
Mr. Sudesh Verma, I think you've gone on mute by mistake. Mr. Verma, I think you've gone on mute by mistake.
Yes, Tanvi, I was saying that let people of this country enjoy that on the one hand, you have Kanhaiya and, other person who are saying that Congress is a sinking ship. Rahul Gandhi needs them to lift the ship up and raise the morale.
We'll come to that point in just a bit, and I'll get the two senior journalists to react on that in just a bit. But Dr. Ahluwalia wanted to make a point. Go ahead, please.
Number one is the things they are deciding. One has already, Sidhu was in BJP for so many years, and now Sidhu is in Congress. So these two parties, why they are debating on each other, I don't understand. The Sidhu has created problem for BJP. Sidhu has created problem for Congress, and Sidhu has created problem for, you can say, Punjab. Now, why Sidhu has created problem? They are only bothered about their chief minister candidate. Nothing else. They are not bothered about what is happening in Punjab. If Sidhu is saying that I am bothered because some of the ministers, what they have taken, they have some, legal issues, some problems. But tell me one thing, why Navjot Sidhu resigned when he was made local bodies minister? What was the problem that time? Now, one of the political analysts is saying that Sidhu is good, Sidhu is this. Then BJP spokesperson saying Sidhu, we don't know about Sidhu. Sidhu was there with BJP, Sidhu was there. Now, the problem is Sidhu is for Punjab. Sidhu is political opportunities. Sidhu wants to become chief minister. Sir, you should be very clear that Sidhu wants to, if you would have made him chief minister, he would not have left your party. Now he wants to be chief minister.
How can we
So it should be very clear that Sidhu is an opportunistic kind of person who has no intelligence. Why no intelligence? Because he cannot wait. He wants everything now, right now, that I want to do this right now. And then he is doing political shows. He is doing comedy shows like this and that. He is doing all kind of tantrums. There's nothing. They are not worried about Punjab people. They are only worried about their own chairs. That is all I want to say.
And that is the message clearly that the Aam Aadmi Party is going to take to the people as they start their campaigning. And it's literally been handed over to them on a platter. But let's get back to what's happening in the Congress Party. And that's, you know, one other thing, Mr. Anand Mishra, the timing of it. I mean, could it have been worse for the Congress? Here was one day where they wanted to show off how they're bringing a change. We've got two youngsters, young blood, being inducted into the party. One of them actually literally came out and said, well, the party needs saving. And at the same time, you've had this, you know, bombshell being dropped. What does it say about the Congress central leadership?
Sidhu's episode has truly come as a spoiler for the merriment of Congress, because Congress was projecting this event of Kanhaiya and Mevani joining the party in a big way. So truly they would not have expected, they would not have liked this such an event in Punjab to play out on the same day. As far as Kanhaiya's statement is concerned, I would say that the statement and words of the leaders won't matter much in the long run. Congress is basically in Bihar, Congress is hurtling from one leader to another to divide itself, to find some space, find a voice. Despite pre-riding RJD for a long time, the Congress is still not a force, major force to reckon with. And there are discomfitures within Congress. There are two voices on the issue of aligning with RJD. So basically, Kanhaiya is an experiment whether Congress can find an independent voice in Bihar. Congress can strengthen the organization to an extent where it does not have to depend on the another party every time to contest an election. I mean, that's a very tall task that Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar is up to. More than Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar, the joining of Mevani is significant for Congress in poll-bound Gujarat. But if you remember, in the last 2017 assembly polls, this is this triumvirate of this Jignesh Mevani, Hardik Patel, and Alpesh Thakur. That has been the main bedrock of Congress support, and they have managed to arrest BJP's numbers to 182 member assembly. After that, Mr. Alpesh Thakur, an OBC, young OBC face, joined BJP. But these two people remained. Hardik Patel became president of Congress, the main partidar face, which BJP has tried to counter this time by bringing back partidar leader, Mr. Bhupendra Patel, in his place. Hardik Patel has young youth at his side. And in Gujarat is very sensitive to Dalit issue. If you remember the 2016 Una incident, or the flogging of Dalit incident, the Dalit, some Dalits, after which Mr. Jignesh Mevani shot into limelight. Then he contested the 2017 assembly polls with the independent backing of Congress. Now Congress is basically trying to send out a big message to Dalits, not only in Gujarat or Punjab, but also significant in UP, where it has higher stakes. Because see, Mevani joining Congress or Mevani is promising to join Congress is happening days after Congress has named Mr. Channi a Dalit, the first Dalit Chief Minister of Punjab. If you remember in 2011, Mr. Rahul Gandhi is dying with Dalit programs in UP. I mean, Congress has focused big on it, but Congress had no organization in the state. So beneficiary of this anti-BJP sentiment or Congress reach out to Dalits was Samajwadi Party. Now it is to be seen how these two incidents, I mean, these two events, anointing Mr. Channi at the first Dalit CM of Punjab and having Jignesh Mevani in the party fold officially, helps Congress. Congress is clearly looking beyond it. Say Congress old combination was this Dalit and Brahmin. So it's also a kind of attempt to revive the old support base.
Okay, if it's the cast card that they look to play, we have to see how it plays works out. Jignesh Mevani, though, as an independent MLA, still hasn't resigned, so he can't officially join the Congress Party. He was there for all other optics purposes. But Congress Party is like a big ship. If it is saved, I believe many people's aspirations, Mahatma Gandhi's oneness, Bhagat Singh's courage, and B.R. Ambedkar's idea of equality will be protected too. That is why I have joined it. If it is saved, what a statement to make, Narendranath Mishra, by Kanhaiya on a day like today.
You, तन्हे एक्चुअली में आज जैसे आनंद जी ने कहा कि एक ऑप्टिक्स एक बड़ा एक ऑप्टिक्स देना था, वो सिद्धू ने स्पॉइल कर दिया एक मैसेज में कि कहीं ना कहीं कांग्रेस जो लगातार पिछले एक दो महीने में जो हुआ उनको लगा कि जैसे आज यहाँ भी कई जगह पे होगी कांग्रेस की एक अपनी कोई आइडियोलॉजिकल ग्राउंड नहीं बच गई थी। एक बीजेपी अपना एक हिंदुत्व हो या नेशनलिस्ट एक जो इमेज लेके चल रही हो या इवन एक लेफ्ट का भी था, तो कहीं ना कहीं कांग्रेस को लग रहा है कि उसके पास एक आइडियोलॉजिकल कोई प्लान नहीं है जिस पर वो एक कर सके। तो एक जो अभी जो एक्सरसाइजेस हो रही हैं जिसमें इंक्लूडिंग द पंजाब एक्सरसाइज जिसको मैं इंपॉर्टेंट मानता हूँ कि चन्नी हो एंड जो कन्हैया को आज लाया गया वो जो जिग्नेश के बारे में वो दलित वास का, तो कांग्रेस एक अपना जो आइडियोलॉजिकल प्लान एक एंड द सेकेंड थे कि कोई भी एक मेरा वोटर का एक बेस होना चाहिए। जैसे पहले जैसे बीजेपी के पास पहले अर्बन वोटर एंड द अपर कास्ट था, उसको मोदी उसको इलेक्ट्रोल में उसको मोर लाइक का एक ओबीसी का एक बड़ा अम्ब्रेला बना दिया। तो एक आपके पास बेस होना चाहिए। आरजेडी के पास बिहार में कुछ भी कभी नहीं वोट मिलता है तो एक मुस्लिम यादव का एक माइक उनका समीकरण था। तो एक हमेशा एक आप एक आपका एक बेस होता था जिस पर आप उससे अधिक मिलने पर आप जीतेंगे नहीं तो एक हारेंगे जो भी होता था। कांग्रेस के पास अभी कोई एक ऐसा कोई बेस ही नहीं था जिस पर आप बैंक कर सके। तो एक दलित वाला जो अभी लग रहा है कि एक सीरियस इसका आप यूपी में भी असर देख सकते हैं, इसका और भी स्टेट में जो कांग्रेस के अंदर जो मीटिंग्स हो रही हैं तो उनमें लग रहा है कि एक कांग्रेस अपना एक जो दलित का और जो एक आइडियोलॉजिकली यूथ वाला जो भगत सिंह का रेफरेंस आया, इक्वलिटी का रेफरेंस आया, जो कन्हैया को लेकर जिसमें अपने भी रिस्क भी है, जैसे कन्हैया का जानते हैं कि जो अपोजिशन का जो एक रहा है कि आपका वो उनको जो आरोप लगाते हैं वो रिस्क लेते हुए कि ठीक है फेयरलेस खेलना है, अगर मुझे जब तक एक आइडियोलॉजिकल जब तक स्टैंड नहीं लेंगे तब तक मेरा कोई टेकर नहीं होगा, हम कंफ्यूज पार्टी दिखेंगे, हमसे कोई एसोसिएट लेना नहीं चाहेगा। तो कहीं ना कहीं जो कांग्रेस का मूव है वो एक थॉटफुल लग रहा है एज ऑफ नाउ कि मुझे कुछ करना है, एक आइडियोलॉजिकल पोजिशन लेना है और मुझे एक डायरेक्शन लेना है। उसका प्रीमियम मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा वो कमिंग डेज में वो होगा, लेकिन ये पहली बार एक डायरेक्शन लग रहा है कि मुझे इस डायरेक्शन में लेके आगे बढ़ना है।
बट ये ही चीज जो अगर वो पंजाब में भी प्रोजेक्ट करना चाह रहे थे, अब वो विल पीपल स्टिल बाय दैट मिस्टर नरेंद्र नाथ मिश्रा? बिकॉज इतना अब ये केओस और कंफ्यूजन हो रहा है, पता नहीं आगे क्या होगा, बट चन्नी एज चीफ मिनिस्टर विल दैट स्ट्रेटजी स्टिल वर्क?
यस, और वो यही चीज एक बार आनंद जी ने भी कह रहा था, उसी चीज को मैं कंटिन्यू कर रहा हूँ कि पंजाब में दो चीजें देखने की जरूरत है, एक कैप्टन एंड इशू ऑफ कैप्टन एंड सिद्धू, वो दोनों बहुत ही मेस्ड है। बट वहां पे अगर आप सिंस बिफोर इवेंट बिफोर कैप्टन एंड सिद्धू देखिए, कांग्रेस का वहां पंजाब में 30% से एक बेस वोट रहा है वहां पे। तो अगर कांग्रेस इस एक्सपेरिमेंट में अगर दलित का वोट लेने मतलब अभी ये सारा कुछ है कि उसमें कि अगर उनका ये बैंक है कि अगर वो दलित का वोट अगर चन्नी के एक्सपेरिमेंट से वो लेने में सफल होते हैं तो वो रेस में होंगे, क्योंकि बाकी जो उनके सामने ऑपोजिशन है वो भी उनके भी हाउस अभी ऑर्डर में नहीं है, चाहे बीजेपी हो या आप हो या अकाली हो, तो इवन कांग्रेस के भी हाउस ऑर्डर में नहीं है या और किसी के भी ऑर्डर में नहीं है। तो ऐसा होगा कि वहां भी जो एक्सपेरिमेंट है चन्नी का, अगर वो एक दलित का एक बंच वोट मिल गया जो सबसे बड़ा वोट वहां पे माना जा रहा है, और एक कांग्रेस का अपना कैलकुलेशन है कि जट सिख में अगर अकाली का भी कुछ से है या आपका भी से है, अगर बीजेपी का भी कुछ होगा, तो एक अभी वहां पे कांग्रेस सही है फैक्ट वहां से जो कांग्रेस का एक पुराना बेस रहा है चन्नी के आने के बाद, तो इसे कांग्रेस को एज अ पार्टी वहां डिसमिस नहीं कर सकते हैं। हाँ, इनको लेकिन ये सिद्धू एंड अमरिंदर ये दोनों अपने ऑप्शंस को काफी लिमिटेड कर रहे हैं इस पूरे एपिसोड में।
Yes, Sujata Paul, then despite this, what your party calls a master stroke of finding a Dalit chief minister and putting him there, minus Captain and minus Sidhu, how will it work?
Look, as far as, I was watching what you were showing while Mr. Mishra was talking. And it's amazing, you're talking about the young Turks who've left. If you look at the young Turks who've left, who've gone basically because they wanted a position. Each one of them has reached the Rajya Sabha. And of course, in Jitin Prasad's case, he has gone he's now been made a minister also, I believe. Now, when you look at those people who are joining, who are these people? They are fresh blood. That is what this country needs. And when you're talking about Punjab, the master stroke still remains Mr. Channi. Nobody is disputing that. And, you know, anybody who says that, no, he should not have been the chief minister is clearly anti-Dalit. Now, when we are talking about India, our constitution very clearly enshrines in it the fundamental principle of everybody being taken along. There is no problem with anybody switching sides. But is it correct that only those people who wanted to, go to the Rajya Sabha, get some power, have been taken by the BJP? That is the kind of politics that the country is facing today. And if you look at the Congress party, it is reinventing itself under the leadership of Rahul Gandhiji. And it is very clear that he might come across as an idealistic person, but ideals is what got India its freedom, and ideals is where India will be taken, along
so with... So you agree with what Kanhaiya Kumar is saying, that this party needs saving and that saving will come from the likes of Kanhaiya Kumar?
I want to come to that. Very important that in India, the youth of this country believe that the party needs to be reinvented. What you interpret out of what he says about saving is what is reinvention. It is the old guard which is giving way now. How it is giving way is thanks to Rahul Gandhi. Rahul Gandhi is ensuring that there is fresh blood which is being infused into the party. And you will have to wait and watch, but you will see politics changing in our country, and the Congress party will only go from strength to strength.
Okay. Okay, I'm a little short on time, but quick response from Sudesh Verma.
I just need to point out a few things that established young leaders like Jitin Prasada, he is in the BJP. Jyoti Dalit Sindhya, he is in the BJP. Hemant Biswa Sarma, who is such a talented man, he is in the BJP. He has given us so many government. He's given us to Prasad. So what are they doing? Kanhaiya is not there with the Congress because of ideological reason. Understand it. Understand it that he has junked his ideology. The CPI, you can imagine, he is going to be another Sidhu. These people are all going to be Sidhu. Rahul Gandhi would be happy only with people like Sidhu, because he cannot digest those leaders who have spent substantial years in politics and they have contributed, because they can pose a challenge to him.
Okay.
He needs people like Kanhaiya, isn't it?
No, so Jadabal, we were not able to hear you, because if two people talk, the voice automatically gets cut. Now say what you're saying.
Yes, what I'm saying is, he's saying that we've taken these winners. How? Jitin Prasad has not won an election in the last two elections that he contested. If you look at Jyotiraditya Sindhya, he lost. If you look at all these leaders who have left, it is only...
Okay, we're going a little off track now, because if that's the argument that you're presenting, the person you've brought on to your party today has also lost the only election that he fought, actually, after he got out of college. So that's where things stand. But I'm completely out of time. So thank you to all five of you for joining me on this conversation. Here is where things stand. Navjot Singh Sidhu has quit as the Punjab Congress chief. Four of his other backers and aides have also quit their party posts or the minister post in Punjab government. The Congress party leadership has nothing to say about it so far. Stunned silence from the party high command, whether it's Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi or anybody else. Now, they are saying, sources suggest that the state leadership will deal with it. One wonders who the state leadership is when half of them have actually already quit. Captain Amrinder being the one who came out and spoke, and he said, "I told you so," to Captain Amrinder, who had challenged that he will not allow Navjot Singh Sidhu to become the chief minister, is out of the game in the national capital, though he still says he will continue with his political fight. Navjot Singh Sidhu is still throwing tantrums. He says he will only speak to the Gandhis and nobody else. There is no explanation as to what has happened, no conversation yet. There is absolutely no meeting, no conversation from both sides as of now. That remains to be seen. But even if they're able to somehow resolve this current crisis, can the Congress party actually recover from it and still go on to win the elections in Punjab? Or will they at some point look back at this time and wonder how they destroyed it all by themselves? Thank you for joining us on this conversation.
Maybe we should get married. Well?
MG Aster, the AI affair.
Hi, kya chal raha hai?
Hey, what's going on?
Tune suna kya? Exam hall ke samne kya scene
Did
hua
you listen?
Tha?
What happened in front of exam
kya
hall?
Kar rahi ho, mama?
Preparing you for college, my dear.
Yaha.
International.
बड़े सपनों को सच करने के लिए चाहिए सही प्लान्स, इसलिए मैं चुनती हूँ PNB MetLife के चाइल्ड एजुकेशन सॉल्यूशन। तो आप भी मेरी तरह कीजिए बड़े सपनों की तैयारी।
आज मेरे पास गर्लफ्रेंड है, वीडियो गेम्स है, सोफा है, खाना है।
तुम्हारे पास क्या
है? उसके पास अपनी 10 लाख की नौकरी भी है। लॉकडाउन में भी बेनेट यूनिवर्सिटी के हर तीसरे स्टूडेंट को 10 लाख से ज्यादा की नौकरी मिली।
कौन बोला?
तो ड्रामा कर पर बेनेट यूनिवर्सिटी में अप्लाई भी कर।
I say absolutely I don't tweet unless I mean it. And what is my tweet you can quote?
सर सर आपको लगता है कि सिद्धू साहब की वजह से आपको अपना पोस्ट गंवाना पड़ा? अब वो भी उन्होंने रिजाइन कर दिया है। आपको लगता है कि उनकी वजह से ही आपको अपना पोस्ट गंवाना पड़ा, आपको इस्तीफा देना पड़ा?
That was nothing to do with Sidhu. Sidhu को जब मैं कह रहा हूँ कि इज अनस्टेबल तो उसको कोई रिएक्शन तो होगा ही, कुछ क्या कहा होगा। मैंने किसी को कुछ नहीं कहा, किसी पॉलिटिशियन को मैं नहीं मिल रहा, कोई पॉलिटिकल एक्टिविटी नहीं है। मैं कपूरथला हाउस जो चीफ का घर है उसको खाली करने के लिए आया।
सिद्धू के इस्तीफे के बाद अब आप क्या
रोल है? ये आप AICC से पूछिए।